move on to the next topic, which is system. System definition is a system which operates on signal. A system which responds to a signal. The input signal is called excited signal, and the response of the system is called responded signal. And the mathematical representation is y of t is equal to h of, generally system is represented by h of x of t. Classification of systems. In 5 ways, the systems can be classified like static and dynamic systems, time invariant variant, linear and nonlinear systems, causal and non-causal, stable and unstable systems. Static and dynamic means static systems are memoryless. Memoryless systems. Memory is not required for the system. That means present output y of t depends only on the present input, but not on past inputs and future inputs. Past input means x of t minus 1 is the past. Future inputs means x of t plus 1 is the future input. Static memoryless system means the present output only depends on the present input, but not on past input, but not on future input. And dynamic systems means are memory systems. That means opposite to the static systems, the present outputs depends on present input, past input and future input. Next classification is time invariant and variant. Time invariant means for x of t, the system response is y of t. If input is delayed by the amount of m, the same must be reflect on response also with the same amount of delay. If input is delayed by m units, the output also must be delayed by the m units. Let us check like this. X of t input and delay by m units means it is x of t minus m, and it is passed through a system. The system which reacts to the delayed input signal, which is y1 of t, that is h of x of t minus m. I can call it as response of delayed input. And second one is the original signal and passed through a system which is y of t. Now it's delay by m units y of t minus 1, that is y2 of t is equal to y of t minus m. I can call it as delayed output. If y1 of t is equal to y2 of t, then such system is called time invariant. If not, it is called time variant. Let us check for this example. If y of t is equal to 2t x of t, then y1 of t will be response of delayed input. Only input must be delayed. Equation number 1 it is, which is y1 of t. Now y2 of t is delayed output. Entire output should be delayed. Wherever the time is there, that time should be delayed. X of t minus m. Okay. Then here y1 of t is not equal to y2 of t. Then such a system is called time variant. Such a system is called time variant. Now the third classification, which is linear and non-linear. Linear and non-linear system, it has to follow the superposition principle. Superposition principle. It has to follow the super, that is algebraic principle, which is h of a1 x1 of t plus a2 x2 of t must be equal to a1 h of x1 of t plus a2 h of x2 of t. Let us check with one example. Here y1 of t is equal to t into x1 of t. If x1 of t is the input, then y2 of t will be t into x2 of t. It's linear combination. A into y1 of t plus b into y2 of t. That will be a t x1 of t plus b t x2 of t, which is equation number 1. Then input linear combination. Let x3 of t is equal to a into x1 of t plus b into x2 of t. It's linear combination of input. Then y3 of t is equal to t into x3 of t. Substitute the linear combination here. A into x1 of t plus b into x2 of t, which is a t x1 of t plus b t x2 of t. So this we can write as a into y1 of t plus b into y2 of t. So I can write y3 of t is equal to a into y1 of t plus b into y2 of t. Then if I able to write like this in the linear combination, then such signal is called linear signal, if not non-linear. Move on to the next, causal and non-causal systems. Causal and non-causal systems means, causal system means the present output. Causal system means, causal system means causal and non-causal systems. Causal system means the present output depends only on, the present output depends only on present input, past input, past input, past output, but not on future input. Future input and output, but not on future input and output. So in that case, if it follows, the signal is called, sorry, the system is called causal system. If it follows all, if the system depends on every present input, past output, future input and future output, then such system is called non-causal system. Let us check with one example. Y of t is equal to x of t minus 2 plus 2 into x of t. Then here x of t minus 2 means what? This is past input and this is present input. Such signal is causal. Now this signal is causal. For example, y of n is equal to, another example, y of n is equal to x of n minus 2 plus x of n minus 1 plus n into x of en. Then again this is past input and this is also past input and this is present input. Again the system is causal. Okay, and next classification is And next classification is, last classification is stable and unstable system. Stable and unstable. Stable means it has to follow the bounded input and bounded output condition. If the input is bounded and output must be the bounded. That means the signal amplitude should be finite. The signal amplitude should be finite. In the ramp case, the signal amplitude is not finite, it is infinity. The signal amplitude infinity. So this is not a stable system. This is unstable. And these amplitudes are finite. These amplitudes are finite. This is stable system. This is unstable system. The necessary and sufficient condition for the system to be stable is integration minus infinity to infinity mod h of t dt should be less than infinity.